Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome back to school. Today is Tuesday, January 19th, 2021. We're glad you're back with us for a day of learning on this terrific Tuesday. Hey, you know what? On Friday, I made a lot of mistakes during the radio show. I don't know if you caught them or not, but I know a couple of students and staff members caught a few of my mistakes on Friday. You know what? We all make them. And just know that you're gonna make mistakes today, and you'll make mistakes probably every day. We all do. So what you do is you learn from them and try and do better. So on this radio show, I think I started off with the right date, January 19th today. On Friday, it was January 15th. Martin Luther King Jr.'s actual birth date is January 15th. And I said January 21st. I wanna thank Kate Giannis for sending me an email letting me know that. Great job, Kate. I appreciate kids listening to the radio show and then letting me know if you see something that doesn't look right. That's okay to let adults know as well as other kids because we're all in this together learning. So thanks, Kate, for that. And then the second thing I did was I said Martin Luther King Jr. He was born on January 15th, 1929. And real fast in my head, I said, that would make him 102 years old. And that was wrong. Actually, Martin Luther King Jr., last Friday, he would have been 92 years old, 92. And actually, Mrs. Mullen, our health room paraeducator assistant, was the one who caught that one. So I wanna thank those of you who are keeping me on track each day. I hope you're listening to the radio show and you're listening closely to make sure that I'm saying the right things. Oh my goodness. Hey, yesterday was our celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. So we had yesterday off on Monday, and it's a chance to celebrate his life and what he talked about and what he stood for. So what he said is, if you don't like the way something is, if you disagree with especially justice for people, meaning that all people, no matter what your skin color, is that all people should be created equal and have equal rights and equal opportunities for things. And so that's really his message that he sent out. But his big message, I think, for me was that he believed in doing that in a non-violent way. So he didn't mind protesting, but his protests were more walks or marches or sit-ins where they would sit. And so his whole way was to be peaceful. Because what he always said was, hate does not help hate. Love is what overcomes and conquers hate. So he just believed in love. And I think that's what we at Freilands really believe in as well, is that kindness and love win out every time. So as you start off on this terrific Tuesday, I want you to think about love and kindness for each other. That means in your family. I know you've been home a lot doing your distance learning. But just keep in mind that keep that love for your family, that means your brothers and sisters, and that kindness for your brothers and sisters and anyone else in your family, whether that be parents or you live in with grandparents or you live in a home with, you have a few families living together. We all need our space and we all need kindness and love. So think of that as you start off on your day. How can you share your kindness with others? Because what I find is when I'm kind with others, if I give love to other people, then I get that back. So when I smile and say hi, when I talk with people nicely, when I see someone with a problem and I'm trying to help them out, I find that when I do that, then people do that back to me. And it's the opposite. When we are not very nice with other people, if we don't treat them very respectfully, if we say negative things to them, then they're gonna do that back to us. And so that's, I think, the big message we can take away for today is let's have some love and kindness towards each other. Let's have a great day of learning together. And we can do that if we can be respectful with each other and be part of helping people get better each day. You know, our Freilands family has a school rule that we follow. At Freilands Elementary School, we respect everyone's feelings and property and their right to learn and be safe. And so you can see that message within our school rule that we've got. Hey, you know what? As you get started on this day, some of you are going to be doing some more iReady testing to see how you're doing. A lot of students did reading last week. If you got through that, great job. Today, I know first graders will be starting reading this week, and our other grade levels will be getting into their math. So we have some iReady assessments. Just do the best that you can with them. We don't want any help from parents. We just want kids to do their iReady diagnostic, and we just want to see what you know. We're at almost the halfway point of the school year, so let's see what you know and what you can do with either reading or math. So good luck with that this week. Also, boys and girls, it is a short week because we were off yesterday, so you've got 4 days this week to work hard. Let's do your best each day. So let's set a goal for yourself today and see if you can reach that goal, and then set a different goal for tomorrow, see if you can reach that goal. I find when I set goals just each day, it helps me focus on that day and try and accomplish some things so I can feel pretty good about how I'm doing. And I know that by the end of the week, I've made most of my goals, or all of them even, by setting them on a daily basis. So keep that in mind. Hey, let's see. Today we do have one birthday to announce. Happy birthday today to Ava Russell. Happy birthday, Ava. You can come and pick out of the birthday bucket today or one day this week. All right, boys and girls, maybe we'll see you, kindergartners, we'll see you soon. And then our students who may be coming for lunches. Remember, it's 11:30 to 1:30 each day. I want to thank Miss Claudia and the kitchen staff who do an awesome job every day providing our lunches for our students out there in the cold weather in the wintertime, and doing a great job in doing that. And you notice Miss Claudia, how positive she is, how caring and loving she is. I think she shows a lot of a great example and model of what we should be doing every day. Smiling and saying hi to everyone, being positive with everybody, being kind, having that kind heart. So I think Miss Claudia is a great example of that. And all of our kitchen staff who make your lunches with love and kindness every day. All right, boys and girls, have a terrific Tuesday. And always remember, your Fryland's family cares about you. All right, boys and girls, lead your families in the Pledge of Allegiance. And kindergartners, why don't you lead your teachers in the Pledge of Allegiance today? All right, take care. We'll see you soon.